Today we're going to be talking about Mary Visits Elizabeth, and we're reading from my nephew's Bible. I borrowed it for these videos so I could read out of a different children's Bible than the Bible that I've already read out of. Okay, so hopefully this angle's okay. Using my camera, so hopefully all of it's all good, and I'm gonna try to maybe zoom in a little bit. Okay, here we go. We'll zoom in a little bit. Soon after this, Mary went to visit her cousin Elizabeth. As soon as Elizabeth saw her, to salute his little cousin, she knew then that Mary's baby would be the Savior God she was happy and excited, and she asked Mary, and her special baby would feed the poor and the hungry and bring hope to the people who were unloved. She stayed with her cousin for 3 months until it was nearly time for Elizabeth's baby to be born. Then she went home to Nazareth say Joseph. Sorry about that. That was kind of blurry down there. But anyways, that's the picture, the little illustration. I'm sorry about the shadows and all that. My camera's not wanting to focus, but here's the picture. It's very pretty. And you can see John, the birth of John the Baptist. So, I'm doing a little different thing. I'm holding the camera for a second here. So, hopefully it's not too shaky. I may put it down in a second, but I just wanted to show you the page really, really well, because angle that I got is just not very good. But that's the children's Bible. When Elizabeth and Zachariah's baby was born, all their friends and neighbors were delighted for them. "The Lord had blessed you with this baby," they said, but Zachariah still couldn't speak. When the time came to name the baby, all the friends and the neighbors said, "Of course, call him Zachariah after his father." But Elizabeth, the baby's mother, said, "We are going to call him John. But John is not a name used by your family. Okay, let's move this down here and focus it. Focus it, focus it. If it'll focus, I don't know if it will or not. It's not doing very well. Anyways. Zachariah wrote, "His name is John," in a large letter. a writing tablet and showed it to everyone. Everyone present. They were all amazed. Then Zachariah's speech returned, and he was able to tell everyone that his son must be called John. So that is Augustus, Emperor of Rome, wanted to know how many people were in his empire. He wanted to know if they were all were paying their taxes. He sent out an order across the Roman Empire, demanding that everyone return to their town where their family came from, so that their names could be written down and counted. Joseph's family came from Bethlehem, a town in Judea, and he and Mary, now his wife, had to go back there, and there was a long, tiring journey from Nazareth, especially for Mary. Her baby was due to be at last. After traveling for many days and nights, she and Joseph arrived in Bethlehem. Come to have their names written. So there's Mary and Joseph with the donkey. As usual, the night sky above the shepherds became a blaze of light, and an angel of the Lord appeared before them. The shepherds covered their eyes because they were so afraid. They wondered what was happening. "Don't be frightened," said the angel. "I come with good news, which will bring great joy for the world. A special baby has been born in Bethlehem today. He is God's promised King, your Savior. Go and see the baby. He is sleeping in a manger." Host of angels singing. So this is a beautiful, beautiful picture right here. Really pretty. We have the beautiful stars. We have the little hills behind them. We have them on their knees, afraid, with bunches of sheep. There's the angels. Wow, how pretty this picture is. It's like ombre pretty. It's really pretty. So the sky was filled with hosts of angels singing, "Glory to God in the highest, peace to everyone on earth." The angels disappeared, the bright light faded, and the sky became dark again. The shepherds knew they had not been dreaming, and after making sure their sheep were safe, they hurried off to Bethlehem to find a special baby, God's promised king. The shepherds found Mary, Joseph, and their baby in Bethlehem, just as the angel had said. When they saw Jesus lying in the manger, they kneeled down and worshipped him. The shepherds told Mary and Joseph all the things the angels had said to them. They tended their flocks earlier that night. Then they went back to the field again, praising God as they went. The night of Jesus' birth was one they would never forget. This is really, really pretty. And to what I would say too about the Christmas story, and when we read this always, I just love how the first people that he told was shepherds. Not a very respectable job in that time. I just think it was very, very awesome. Showed up to the most unlikely people, and it's just the same how God works today. Today, God can work through the most unlikely people, and it's just so beautiful because we of ourselves. So it says around the time Jesus was born, some wise men in the east noticed a special star. They knew this was a sign that a great king had been born. They decided to follow the star and find out where it led. The wise men packed everything they needed for their journey. They took gifts with them for a royal baby. They traveled for many days and nights. Until they arrived in Jerusalem, they went straight to the palace where is the baby who is born to be king of the Jews. They asked, "We have seen the star, and we have come to worship him." King Herod was angry. He sent for his advisors and asked them about this new king and where he could be found. God's prophets have written that the king will be born in Bethlehem in Judea. They told him Herod sent the wise men on to Bethlehem to find the baby. "Come back and tell me where you find him," said Herod. "I want to take him a present too," which he was lying there, if you guys don't know. But anyways, there's the little illustration there of the wise men. Show it to you. Sorry about this camera, it's just not wanting to focus, but that's that. So we're gonna move on to the next page. wise men left Jerusalem and looked, and looking up in the skies, they were delighted to see a beautiful star that they had seen before. They followed the star, and when it stopped over one of the houses in Bethlehem, they knew they had found their king. They saw the baby Jesus with his mother Mary and kneeled before him, giving him gifts: gold, frankincense, and myrrh. God knew that Herod meant harm for baby Jesus, so he visited the wise men in a dream. He warned them not to go back to Herod, but to go home another way. Then God sent a messenger to warn Joseph too. Herod wants to kill the baby, said the messenger. You must take him and Mary to Egypt. At once, stay there until I tell you it is safe to return. Joseph and Mary quickly gathered their things together, and in the middle of the night they took Jesus and fled to Egypt. They stayed in Egypt until it was safe for them to go home to Nazareth. So, this is the little illustration of Joseph, Mary, and baby Jesus in a donkey. So that's really cute. But that is about it. I'm just gonna leave it there. But I hope you guys enjoyed this little series of me reading these little Bible stories from this children's Bible. But I love you guys, and Jesus loves you. I hope you guys have a Merry, Merry Christmas. And I'll see you, Lord willing, in another video soon. Bye, guys. Bye, guys. Bye, guys.